Welcome students to our English class standard 12. Today we will study about elements of novel. This is the second part of history of novel 4.1. So let's begin. In history of novels, we have seen very many types of the novels described. So here we are going to study exactly what these types of novels are, what are the different forms. The first one is the realistic novel. Realistic novel is a fiction novel that is real and is also called as a novel of manners. Here in realistic novel, the characters are complex characters with mixed motives in the social class. That is, they are simple but they are having a complex characters, that is they have different roles to play, and they are mixed in the social class, that is based on the real society. Realistic novel also has a day-to-day experiences. The characters and the story is based on general daily experiences and general characters, very simple characters. So realistic novel is also called as novel of manners. The examples of realistic characters are Fault in Our Stars by John Green or Swami and His Friends by R.K. Narayan. So we can see what is happening around us in the novel that we are reading. That is known as realistic novel. Picaresque novels. This is the form of novels where the hero is in poor conditions and lives for his wits. That is, he is having his own ideals and he is fighting against the corrupt society. So this is the main style of genre of prose writing where the hero is going against the society for his own achievement of goals. He adopts the picaresque novel writers adopt the realistic style of writing. They can adopt the comedy or satire style and they write the novels. Picaro, the word means rogue. Rogue, that is rough, behaving in a different way than others. Hero might also harm others for his own goals or ideals. That is picaresque novels, right? Novel writing. Examples of picaresque novels are Adventures by Mark Twain, The Guide by R.K. Lakshman, The White Tiger, Kim by Rudyard Kipling. Historical novel. As the name suggests, it is based on history. The past events are described in this novel. The setting of this novel is in the past. When the writer writes the novel, he describes about the past, and the social conditions, the manners are described of past, but it is realistic with the details of past age. History fiction is a genre which the plot takes place in the setting located in the past, and the writing is called as historical novel. Examples are Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens, War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy, The Great Indian Novel by Shashi Tharoor, Train to Pakistan by Kushwant Singh, Discovery of India by Jawaharlal Nehru. Epistolary form of novel is written as a series of documents. It is written in the form of diaries or letters and or radio broadcast or in the newspaper clippings and other documents. Epistolary is the word derived from epistola, which means letters. Examples like Diary of a Young Girl by Anne Frank, Dracula, Barnstalker. Color Purple, that is written by Alice Walker. Here she writes the novel is a good example of epistolary novel, in which the improvised black teenage girl Sally, she tells the story through writing letters to her sister and to God. Gothic novels are the novels that includes the terror, mystery, horror, thriller, supernatural or death decay or haunted buildings. So these novels consider the horror stories or that are based on romance or death. Generally, it is based off terrifying the readers. That is Gothic novels. The Dark Bungalow, A Ghost in Burma, A Woman and the Child, The Woman in Black are some of the examples of Gothic novels. There is a different class of people who are very much interested in reading Gothic novels and very curious about knowing such type of stories. Autobiographical novel is based on the life of the author. Author himself write his own life story. Author can change the place, the name of the characters, or even he can change certain details of his life. The novel may or may not be written in the first person. That is, he may tell the story by himself, or in a story form he can write the narration of the story. Waiting for Visa by B.R. Ambedkar, The Story of My Experiments with Truth by M.K. Gandhi, Boyhood by Leo Tolstoy, Long Walk to Freedom by Nelson Mandela are very, very beautiful autobiographical novels. The word allegory is a Greek word which means to imply something other. The author may use allegory to illustrate a spiritual truth or a political or historical situation he wants to give. Its symbolic meaning is deeper than the what actually it conveys. They may have what the word actually says. It might have the meaning other than that. Some of the examples, the stories with morals are allegoric stories. It has a different level of meaning. You can understand by the Aesop fables, the stories with morals, the story Hare and the Tortoise. With this story, we can understand that actually it was a race between the hare and the tortoise. But the meaning that the moral that the story wants to convey is slow and steady wins the race, which means they want to convey, the writer wants to convey the exact moral of the story and not the story of the hare and the tortoise. So one more story, allegorical novel, is Animal Farm, where by George Well. Here the animals want to bring equality in the society, and this idea is very well forwarded by Orwell through animals. Ethiopian and dystopian novels are the two different opposite forms where the two different communities are taken into consideration. The word Ethiopia, from the Greek word eu means no or not, and tops means the place. Now Ethiopia is an imaginary community where the society is possessing the ideal qualities, where everything is perfect. Whereas dystopia, on the other hand, the world where nothing is perfect, everything is wrong over there. Both these Ethiopian and dystopian share the characteristics of science fiction and fantasy. These are the imaginary places. Nothing can be perfect or nothing can be imperfect. So Ethiopian and dystopian are the two different forms, opposite forms, and generally they are science fiction, imaginary, fantasy novels. Both are usually set in the future, where technology has been used to create a perfect living condition. It is based on the technologies and on the future tense. Now, Ethiopian and dystopian novels keep the readers hooked till the end, which makes one question what it really means. Like, they are curious about what is going to happen, or can this actually happen? The Machine, Time Machine by H.G. Wells, Republic by Plato, News from Nowhere by William Morris, or Utopia by Thomas More are very good examples of Ethiopian novels. Psychological novels. This is the work of Friction that treats the internal life of a protagonist, the hero, and with the other characters, and the external factors also are considered. The state of mind of a hero, what is the psychological behavior of that hero is treated in this novel. What type of behavior the protagonist goes through, the characters go through, and the reasons why their behavior is in that way, all these things are explained in the story, in the psychological novels. A Bend in the River by V.S. Naipaul, The Glass Palace by Amitav Ghosh, The God of Small Things by Arundhati Roy, A Portrait of a Lady by Henry James. These are a few examples of psychological novels. Stream of consciousness is a phrase that is coined by William James in his Principles of Psychology. This was the phrase that was written by William James. Now, it means that the flow of thoughts that are coming into the mind of the novelist and how the novelist writes the incidences that are coming into the mind of the character in the same sequence he goes on writing. In this way, the novel is produced by the author. Ulysses by James Joyce is a novel that tracks a single day in the life of an Irishman, Leopold Bloom. Only one day, what happens in that particular day in the life of Leopold Bloom, that is explained in that complete novel. As I Lay Dying by William Plunker, Molly by Samuel Beckett are the examples of stream of conscious novels. Bildungsroman is a novel on a person's formative years of spiritual education. Now this means that the person's psychological growth from the young to his adulthood, what type of changes are there right from his childhood to the adulthood. All this is presented in the novel. The psychological and moral growth of the protagonist from his youth to adulthood, in which the character is changed, this is presented in the novel. The examples of this Bildungsroman novel are To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. In this novel, the older woman is looking back at the events which led to her loss of innocence and journey to adulthood. Harry Potter and Deathly Hallows by J.K. Rowling is also one of the examples of Bildungsroman novel. Now, this is a very interesting style of writing stories. Pulp magazines were inexpensive fiction magazines. They were published in the 20th century for general entertainment of masses. They were printed on cheap pulp paper. That is why they were termed as pulp magazines. The pulp fiction era provided the ground for detective novels and science fictions. Wolves of Darkness by Jack Williamson or Bullet from Nowhere by Robert are the examples of pulp magazines. Science fiction and detective fiction are some other forms of novels. Here, the concepts of futuristic setting, futuristic science, technology, space travel, time travel, parallel universes, and extraterrestrial life is discussed in science fictions. This genre flourished in 19th century. Frankenstein's Mary Shelley's 1823 is considered to be the first novel on science and technology. Brave New World, The Time Machine by H.G. Wells, Aliens in Delhi by Sami Ahmed Khan. These are the few examples of science fiction. After that comes detective fiction. It is a subgenre of crime fiction and mystery fiction in which the investigator or the detective, either professionally or amateur investigator, he investigates about the crime. Often the crime is murder. So these are various forms, various genre of novels, and they are discussed by different writers and presented in a very interesting ways. So the novel becomes very interesting. The combination of characters, the setting, the plot, the theme, all are taken into consideration, and the author writes the novel and develops the story. So this is how the novel becomes a complete book of story and becomes interesting to read. So lastly, we can conclude that a novel is a work of art where the author intervenes the different elements of novel, that is theme, plot, character, setting, conflict, language, and makes the story interesting so as the reader is more interested in reading the novel. Thanks for watching. Till we meet in our next class, goodbye till then. So friends, don't forget to subscribe the channel and share the video, and also to like the video. Thanks for watching.